A Sports Pregame Show.
Ernie Johnson joined by Shaquille O'Neal. Kenny the Jet Smith, thanks for tuning in. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, it's the Washington Wizards as they'll be playing against the Atlanta Hawks. Well, for Atlanta, they've only come out in front in one of their first three games so far. So a win tonight will be important to them, to be at 500 instead of three games under. All right, looking at Jared Sullinger. Came into the league and most thought he would just be a role player, but Kenny, he's shown that when he's healthy, he's on the floor, he can be a significant contributor on offense.
Well, you know, the role player word is a little misused because everyone has a role. Some guys score more, some guys rebound more, some guys assist more. Some guys talk more. And he's added a three-pointer to his game, so that gives him a bigger role, more impact. But you just got to be careful around this guy because you really can, if you're not defending him correctly, he can get 15 to 20 points pretty easily.
Ernie, I hope I don't get in trouble for saying this, but this guy has a back advantage over all the players. He uses his backside very well. Defense, he makes him go where he wants him to go.
I've just been told you can't say that as we turn it over to Kevin Harlan.
Back advantage.
From Washington, D.C., we bring you to the Verizon Center, the home of the Wizards. The Washington Wizards coming to this one following a loss to Atlanta at Phillips Arena. And a very close one there, too. The buzzer sounded. They were only down by one bucket.
I actually thought they might be able to sustain that momentum they picked up in the fourth quarter and grab the win. But it definitely proved anyone wrong who thought early on it wasn't possible. It was possible. It just didn't happen.
And I thought they might make it all the way back, too. You know, definitely made it for an exciting finish. They just came up a shot short.
A look at Atlanta's opening lineup. They've got Young, Lewis Williams out there with Taylor, and there's the monster. And it's Cephalosha in at the three. Now here's Dragic. Ejected by Taylor. Williams passes to Taylor. Here's the monster. Sinks that one from the post.
Yeah, heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
Outside Dragic. He feeds it to Beal. Taylor with the rebound.
And although he doesn't quite get the block, he does get the missed field goal attempt because of his ability to alter the shot.
Well, almost as effective as a block. I mean, made him completely change his release point, and I think that caused the miss.
Taylor against Dragic. Pass to Sullinger. There's a screen by Gortat. Sullinger dishes to Gortat. Five to shoot. Dragic kicks to Jefferson, and he gets it to go.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
Now, here is Young. And here's Cephalosha for three, and Jared Sullinger pulls it down.
Good little two-man action there, but they just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty. Good-looking shot, well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it.
Here in the first quarter, with about 2 minutes gone by,
play him tight. Come on.
Taylor against Dragic. Outside, Taylor. Gortat with the block. And here's the fast break. Beal leading the way. The Wizards shooting their first free throws of this game.
And as a group, they shot 75% from the line last season.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good. Both free throws good for Beal. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Taylor kicks to Williams. There's the pick. Jumper off the screen. That is good.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Now here's Dragic. 11 points last game. Outside for Jefferson. And it's all evened up. Jefferson's got 5 now.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Dragic against Taylor. The pass to Young. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
This is his first free throw of the game.
And you know, you'll take what he can give you from the free throw line. Looking at his numbers, just really not one of his strengths. Shooting in the low 60s last season.
You know, yeah, guys, last year was a rough one for him at the stripe. I mean, it's going to be hard for him not to improve on those numbers. They were that bad.
That free throw good from Thaddeus Young. Both good from the line that time. And here's Dragic. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Sullinger the screen. Now Beal. Lock at 6. Let's it go with a 3. Rebounded by the Hawks. They defeated the Wizards in their last game.
Yeah, the bench production in that game was terrific. Points from multiple sources.
Yeah, everybody that stepped on the floor played and made a contribution, and that's always a positive thing.
And now Beal pushing it up and no one back to stop him. And Jefferson throws it down.
And you can see the importance of that steal. I mean, really a 4-point turnaround with the conversion at the other end right there.
Yeah, the importance of the defense there. Instead of giving up the bucket and having that 5-point deficit, all of a sudden, we got a tie ball game.
The Hawks again can't hit.
And as far as jump shots go, that's what you have to continue to try and get.
I don't know how that one stayed out.
Dragic kicks to Gortat. Pass to Sullinger. And the layup falls.
In that height, with that much of an advantage height-wise, there's just not a lot the defense can do.
Outside, Williams passes to the monster. Screen by Young. There's the screen. Shot, high post. Here's the monster. Lays it up and banks it in.
Just not enough bodies on the glass right there, and they paid for it.
Well, Greg, I know you're a little guy, but you know what it means to box out, and it's an effort thing and a mindset deal. You got to get your body between that other player and the ball.
Here's Sullinger. After the basket by Atlanta, too long in the paint, and he's hit with a 3-second violation. For Washington, they have had 2 chances at the line already, making them both. One shot. outside Dragic. Five on the clock. Sullinger the screen. There's Beal with the three. Can't hit. And Atlanta will go the other way with it. Their last encounter was in Atlanta.
Yeah, a really close game between these two in that last matchup. It took a total team effort for them to get the win.
It sure did. And they got a lot of scoring from their bench, Greg. And I think that really was the crucial difference.
Now here's Jefferson. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Atlanta. From past the arc. And there's Bradley Beal on the assist by Jefferson. And it's 6 points here for Beal. The Hawks trail by four. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Here's the Monster. Knocks down the 10-footer. The Monster's got six.
I tell you what, it's almost like stealing to watch how he plays the game from this seat.
There's a screen by Gortat. Pulls up. And that one comes up a bit short.
Major defensive lapse right there. He's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You've got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for good offense, but that was just a terrible reaction from the defense.
So it's Washington now, following the bucket by the Hawks.
The right thing there to stay that tight on him and really try to keep him out of his comfort zone.
Now here is Cephalosha. He's guarded by Dragic. Now the dish to Taylor. Feeds it to Young. In Atlanta again with the bucket. So timeout called here. The first for Washington. And a chance now to go over to Doris Burke, who had a chance to talk with head coach Mike Budenholzer.
We talked about some of the matchups he'll be watching in this game. And he told me, quote, "I'll be looking at how we deal with Marcin Gortat. He's a guy who can score in any number of ways, posting up, pulling up from outside, or rolling to the rim. And he's also a factor on the glass. Guys, Gortat might not be a household name, but he's an impact big man in this league, no question."
Always great to hear from you, Doris. Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
And a new group getting ready for the Wizards. Benson is checked in for Gortat. John Luehr comes in for Sullinger. Ryan Roberts is checked in for Bradley Beal. And Brooks subbed in for Goran Dragic. Wizards have gone just a shade under 50% from the field. 5 of 11. Roberts passes to Brooks. He dishes it to Luehr. Count it from 12. Luehr's got the game tied up here for the Wizards.
And look at how quick he was to bite on the pump fake. Left his feet way too soon.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game.
Yeah, maybe a change of the game plan right now. Looking at some different sets because of the matchups.
Yeah, I agree with you because they're looking to tweak things to maybe get those matchups working in their favor.
Atlanta's gone 1 of 3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Here's Taylor. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Can't make good off the pick. Over to the left wing. And Jefferson. He has a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
Yeah,
wow.
That could very well be a contender for Dunk of the Year and perhaps might make its way all over the internet.
I tell you what, that is the crowd pleaser of all crowd pleasers.
Taylor's shot, good.
Uh-oh, a little showboating. At the end of that one.
Washington's gone 2-of-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. And Brooks, here we go. Lure, and Capella sends it back.
All right, a moment. Check out the stats for Jefferson. He had a strong showing last season. First in free throw percentage, second in field goal percentage, and he ranked third in assists last season as well. Truly one of the league's preeminent playmakers.
And you know, as you said, Greg, fantastic at the free throw line last year. That's a tremendous asset for any team.
Shoot two.
The first free throw is good. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Now here's Taylor. Against Washington, he was really on his game. Now, here's Exum. Tight defense on him. The 10-footer. And it's Lure with the rebound. Wizards have gone an even 50% from the field. They are 7-of-14 for the game. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Brooks. Lure's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Really a good job recognizing the mismatch. Just going up for the shot with that huge height advantage on that possession.
Exum with it. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Here's Splitter. That drops.
And both teams on fire from the opening tip.
Well, I don't doubt it, Greg. We're going to have an entertaining game of basketball here today. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious that's the case.
Here's Lure. The feed to Jefferson. Wizards passing it around. Clock at six. The high post shot. And that one hits back iron. The Hawks trailing. Now here's Taylor. The fast break opportunity. And out of bounds as the Wizards gain possession. And now, courtesy of the 2K leaderboard, here are the teams that led the NBA in block shots last year. In the third spot, the Hawks.
A big part of their defense really revolved around their ability to block shots at the rim. It's so valuable to have that kind of backline protection. Allows you to be aggressive on the perimeter.
Now here's Brooks. His last outing, he had 8 points. Takes the three. It's up and it's off the mark. He's 0 for 1. There's the screen. Taylor attacking. The timely screen gave him a step and he took it all the way. Taylor's got it all tied up now for the Hawks. And there's a minute 45 left in the first. Kicks to Roberts. Pass to Benson. It's deflected. And here is Taylor. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. That's on Aaron Brooks.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
The Hawks shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
All right now, gentlemen, two shots. Blue shot.
Drops, so they now lead by one. and Taylor drops them both.
And that's another area where he is just a superb player. Excellent at the free throw line.
Brooks against Taylor. Brooks, the pass to Benson. And Jefferson, here we go. Nice fake, but the layup off the mark.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Now here's Taylor. He's got six. He kicks it to Exum. On the wing, Korver misses the three.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the board.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
The Wizards have yet missed a free throw. 5 for 5. The first one falls, and the Hawks making a change here. Ilyasova has checked in. And so he makes both from the line. 32 seconds left to play in the first. Brooks against Taylor. Nice D from Brooks. Washington's gone 2 of 5 from three-point land here in the first quarter. Jefferson has a wide-open look. Knocked loose and stolen by Ilyasova. Here's Korver. And he uses the glass on the layup. Ilyasova's got his first 2 points. Jefferson attacking, can't cash in from close range. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Hawks lead by 2. We'll be back shortly live from the Verizon Center. And a chance to hear from Bradley Beal. He came from a football family in St. Louis, but said his mother introduced him to the game of basketball at a young age.
She definitely put the ball in my hands. She's the one who taught me my form, my follow through, and still to this day, she yells at me if I miss a shot. So she's kind of a perfectionist, and she definitely taught me how to shoot. She can shoot it, and she still to this day thinks she can shoot better than me.
Maybe some other NBA players should be practicing with Bradley Beal's mom, because she has definitely honed something special into him.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, and I'm not sure some of the more delicate NBA egos could handle her trash talking them when she beats them in a game of horse. Bradley's not only got a special J, but he's got a pretty good disposition too.
And off we go. A close game now starting the second quarter. In a moment here to take a look at some of the hustle stats for Atlanta.
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
Yeah, the other thing, though, is they have attacked in the open floor. They're definitely getting a lot of easy ones that way.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the court for Atlanta, Ilyasova out there with Young. That's Tavo Cefalosha. Then it's Williams. And it's the monster in at the 5. The Hawks shooting pretty good tonight at 48%. Williams against Dragic. Shoots it up. Second chance shot. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2. The Hawks have looked good at the line tonight. They're perfect in four attempts. Down the first one. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
It's been a good one for the Monster. He has 8 points and one assist.
And we play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. There's a screen by Gortat. Dragic kicks to Beal. There's the triple. Rebound, Atlanta. The Monster's got 5 rebounds tonight. Now Williams. He's coming off a 13-point game against Washington.
Boy, was he physical, I mean, in that game. Just drawing a lot of contact and getting himself to the line over and over. Just a grinder. Always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. And that's one of the things he brings to the table.
There's a screen by Gortat. Dragic dishes to Beal. And Sullinger kicks to Beal. 6 on the shot clock. The Wizards need to get a shot off here. And he gets it to go. 14 points for Smooth.
Really just a tremendous day for him. And if you remember, he was just as good in their last game.
Williams passes to Ilyasova. Back to Williams. Ilyasova sets a screen for Williams. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. And the Hawks lead by 3. The Wizards have gone 2-of-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Dragic dishes to Sullinger. Down low. The basket drops and gets fouled on the shot. 1 free throw coming his way.
Oh, Maestro, he is so good at making those lead passes. Like conducting an orchestra.
The Wizards have gone a perfect 7-of-7 from the line tonight. Splitters checked in for Atlanta.
One shot. Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
To throw good, Jefferson. Hawks shooting at 48% from the floor. Looking good. Splitter with a screen on Dragic. Williams passes to the Monster. And there's the call on Marcin Gortat. That is his first foul of the game.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Greg, those are always tough to judge, but I think the official got that one right.
And Washington making a change here. Larkin's checked in. And for those of you just joining us, we're in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by. They grab their own miss, the Monster. And you can count it, he'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game. Misses.
You know, he didn't get to the line in that entire first quarter, but right now he's showing some aggressiveness out there.
Nice shot by Larkin.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
Here's Williams after the basket by Washington. Williams double team. Here's the monster. The shot misses. Borjan with the defensive effort. Washington's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Dishes it to Beal. Good opportunity right here. Another one falls for Washington.
Oh, the turnaround jumper. That was just beautiful.
Outside Williams. Makes it off the glass. 14 points for the monster.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
Young against Dragic. It's Beal on the wing. Four on the shot clock. Beal can't get that one to fall.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says, but still anybody's game.
It's Williams with the drive. It's stolen by Dragic. And there's Bradley Beal on the assist by Dragic. Dragic has got three assists now in this one. The Hawks have gotten a little under 50% of their second quarter shots to find the mark. 4 of 9 all told. Williams kicks to Young. There's the pass to the monster. Slides through for his 7th basket in 11 tries.
And now he's taken a solid opening in the quarter and built on it here in the second.
There's a screen by Gortat. Outside Dragic. Inside Lehner. Again the Wizards score.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
Here's Young after the made shot from Goran Dragic. Here's the monster. Again, the Hawks score. Here's Dragic. He feeds it to Beal. There's a screen by Gortat. Beal dishes to Gortat. Here's Sullinger. It's tipped. Here's Cephalosha. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Washington. Splitter, that's good.
And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target.
Dragic against Young. Here's Beal. Sullinger, left side. Here's Larkin. Sinks the three-pointer. Larkin's got 5 points now this quarter. Guys, what a tight start to the game this has been.
You know what? Can you believe there have been 7 lead changes already, guys?
Wow.
And it's still in the first half. This could be a wild one.
Atlanta calls timeout. Making some change. Bridges. Benson is checked in for Gortat. John Luehr comes in for Jared Sullinger. And it's Brooks in for Goran Dragic. And then for Atlanta, Capella's checked in. And it's Korver in for Young. The Hawks have gotten 7 of their 12 field goal attempts to drop here in the second quarter. Up over 50%. Here's Taylor. The shot drops. His shooting percentage improves. He's 3 for 7 now with that basket. No shortage of drama here early on.
Well, neither team can grasp control of this thing. I mean, both teams trying to get a hold of it.
Yeah, 8 lead changes already. Huge number this early.
Now here's Beal. 26 points for him last game against the Hawks in Atlanta.
And not just the scoring. It was also how fierce he was on defense, grabbing 3 steals on the night as well.
Here's Larkin. Atlanta with the rebound.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
Taylor attacking. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. And it's a 3-point Atlanta lead.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there, and a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
They set the pick. Lock at 6. Here's Benson. A terrific shot on the turnaround.
Wow, got that one off right in the face of the big fella. Nice quick fire release.
Yeah, and the mid-range shot really the only option in that situation. Sometimes when you're facing a bigger guy, you can't get it all the way to the rim.
And Atlanta has possession following the bucket by the Wizards. Taylor passes to Korver. Off target from the wing. Washington's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. Pass to Larkin. Offline with his 3. The Hawks leading. Taylor with the ball. Now Beal defending. Taylor kicks to Capella. The Hawks working the ball around. They set the screen. Here's the monster. He's coming off a 13-point game against Washington.
And how about the job he did rebounding as well, guys? I mean, just a dominant performance on the glass.
The Wizards shooting very well, 56% from the floor here in the second quarter. Here's Larkin, 5 points in the game. Brooks dishes to Beal. Passes it to Luehr. Goes up the baseline. And the powerful one-handed slam.
And great effort on the boards. And what a mean that was, Gabby. You just will not see him ever quit on a play.
That guy is a handful. You've got to have a body on him, Clark, at all times.
And you know what? Sometimes that's not even enough. He'll go around, over, or through you to get to the pump.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas.
Here's Luehr. Out to Brooks. There's the triple. Cannot hit. And Atlanta will go the other way with it. When this game is done, they'll be off to Orlando and they'll take on the Magic. That will conclude their brief 2-game road trip. Shot by Taylor, no good.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
And Beal kicks to Larkin. Can't tie it up as that one's no good.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Right through the D for the layup. Taylor's got the lead up to 5 now for the Hawks.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
I tell you, we're taking a look at some real deficiencies defensively. I mean, they've given up 5 straight good looks in the paint.
Here's Larkin. 5 points in the game. The dish to Beal. And he comes off the screen to bury the jump shot. Beal's got 12 points in the game.
And their shots are falling now with more regularity than we saw at first.
Well, it was a slow start, but they've gone from simmer to medium heat, and they're bordering on hot to close this gap.
And since the first quarter, we've seen them ease off on that long-range affair. And frankly, that's probably a good idea.
I know there's some teams out there that would prefer to just shoot their way out of a slump, but, you know, getting a few to drop from in close or inside the arc is often a good way to get your whole offense going.
The Wizards have been at their finest form at the free throw line tonight. 8 attempts, 8 makes.
All right, now, take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And the first one drops. Jefferson's checked in for the Wizards. Ryan Roberts comes in for Larkin. And then for Atlanta, Ilyasova comes in for the Monster. And it's Dante Exum in for Thabo Sefolosha. He doesn't get the second one. They can trade 2-for-1 here.
Would be the right move, I believe, right now.
That one goes. Counts. And the Hawks lead by 6.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area.
And really something that the defense has to address.
27 seconds left now here in the second. And Jefferson sends it back.
They'll probably let the clock wind down here.
Right on. I mean, no need to give the ball back before the end of the quarter in this situation.
Well, he gets it in close, but you have to credit that stifling defense for forcing the miss.
Exactly, Greg. I mean, defense like that really increases the degree of difficulty on that shot by a large amount.
Here's Roberts. In the corner, it's Jefferson. That will count. He got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And so we conclude the first half. It's Atlanta ending the second quarter with a tremendous 17-7 run. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, Goran, how do you rate the team's performance thus far, and what are you expecting in the second half?
I mean, you know, we are battling, we as a team, and if we're gonna play like that, I think so we're gonna be okay.
Goran, thanks for the time. Gotta love it when they battle, guys.
Thank you, Doris. We'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, two quarters down, two to go. Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith as we start breaking it down for you. A competitive matchup for Atlanta in the first quarter. Their largest deficit of the period was just 4 points. They were right there within shouting distance the entire time. They showed their superiority in the second quarter and got well out in front, taking a 9-point lead into the locker room at the half. And Shaq, what are your thoughts on how Atlanta played?
The job their guys have done in the post have been terrific. If they get more of that production in the paint next half, they'll be very tough to beat. They're taking advantage of the late rotations, and they're going right inside and straight to the rim.
Kenny, what's your take on Washington so far?
Well, they're facing a very hot team in the first half. I mean, guys are shooting the ball lights out. But you have to do more to get stops. I mean, tough defense is the key. And if you put pressure on the ball and more bodying up down low, that's going to establish more aggressive tone that might shut them down in the second half.
All right, and that'll do it for us here. We now take you back to the second half of our game. Kevin Harlan ready with the call.
The second half beginning in just a moment. What a game we're seeing from the Monster.
Yeah, you just love it when the decision making is as good as it was there in that first half. Didn't force anything.
Guys, I think here in the second half, though, they may want him to be a little more assertive. Start hunting more for his shot, even the tough ones.